And welcome to it, the day after Election Day here in the state of Maryland. And there will be a new Baltimore County executive. He's a Democrat, and he defeated Al Redmer last night handily. His name is Johnny Olszewski. You better learn how to say his name, because we'll probably be talking about Johnny O for a long time. And Johnny, first of all, congratulations. Quite a victory for you last night. And how much sleep are you on?
Thank you. I'm humbled and grateful for the support that Baltimore County voters gave to us last night, and the support and the trust that they put in me. We're operating on probably about 2.5 or 3 hours sleep at this point.
But, well worth it, I imagine.
Absolutely. And we're charged up. The energy from last night was electric, and it was just great to be surrounded by so many supporters and friends last night.
So let's go back from the beginning here. You win a primary where they are counting votes. They are actually having to go back. It was this ridiculous process, a three-way race where basically Amon, Brochin, and Johnny O are almost identical across the board. You sneak out of that where if one van of people doesn't show up, we're not talking about your victory last night.
That's right. And it was, as we said throughout this campaign in the general, and before I continue, just want to commend Al Redmer for running a spirited campaign. He's a great public servant for the residents of Baltimore County and the state, and I know that he'll continue to serve our residents well. But, yeah, I mean, it was the spirit that we continued through the general. We knew that every vote mattered and that every conversation could have shaped the outcome of this race, and that's how we treated it. There wasn't a whole lot of public information about the state of the race, and we just assumed we were always down 20 points and that we were in a, you know, needed to do all we could. And that's what we did.
Did you have a good idea when you woke up yesterday morning that you were going to win and maybe win going away?
We felt good. We had every reason to be confident walking into it. There was a really just electric energy around the campaign. We had six different campaign offices that were fully staffed every day. Every evening I'd walk in and see new volunteers that I hadn't met, and people who were just excited and charged up were making phone calls and writing postcards, and it was just really a humbling experience for me.
When you finish this up, what was the big message from county voters that they want from their top executive?
I mean, the two things that we based our campaign on, and I think it really resonated with voters, is number one, schools. People want to see their kids go to schools that don't have brown drinking water, that has good infrastructure, that has the right personnel, and then also just transparency and accountability in government, a government that, you know, it puts information online, that has good leads with ethics and is responsive to the needs of our residents. And that's really what we pushed for in this campaign, and that's what I'm looking forward to push for as a county executive.
Johnny O is with us after his 15-point win last night for Baltimore County Executive. What's order of the day number one when you take office and you become Baltimore County's new executive?
Well, at this point, we're just trying to thank our volunteers and get through today. We're going to start, I'm sure at some point in the near future, we'll have transition plans announced, and we'll work through all the details of that. But one of the things I was really proud of, Brett, throughout this campaign was that we released very detailed plans for where we want to take the county. And so all of the things that were on the website before are still there now. And we'd encourage folks to see where we want to take the county. But we will have an inclusive, open process during the transition so that residents can continue to talk to us, because the best leading starts with listening. And so that's what we'll do leading up to the inauguration and starting this administration off.
It's amazing when you look at the numbers, if you're a political geek like me, and you fall, I don't know, 10, 11,000 votes short of Larry Hogan in Baltimore County. Is that about the number? And here you have Larry Hogan, who wins by a huge number statewide. He does really well in Baltimore County. He does really well in Howard County. He does really well in Anne Arundel County. But there is a blue sweep in those Baltimore suburban counties, for the most part, with a few exceptions in Hartford and others. What happened last night? I'm trying to square this in my mind. What happened with this, you know, at least here locally, a blue wave coming in as far as county executives go?
Sure. I mean, I think for us, it was focusing on a combination of focusing both on what we focused, so the issues of education and transparency, public safety and economic development, but also the how we want to govern. And so, you know, the governor and I have both consistently talked about the need to reach across the aisle to get things done, to not let partisanship get in the way of progress. And I think the combination of focusing on the issues people cared about, which I think, you know, a lot of those issues tend to be more Democratic, but they don't, you know, no party has a monopoly on good ideas. But the right issues and the right approach, I think, came together, and were a big part of the reason we were successful last night.
The Olszewskis have been around Baltimore County politics for a long time. From taking a step back point of view to reach the top seat, what does that mean?
Well, I'm just still coming to the realization that we were successful, and I'm again ecstatic for the future of this county, and we hope to build a diverse team that reflects our county's strength and really realizes it our fullest potential. You know, I think I've always said that we live in a good county, but we want to make this a great county, one of the best counties that are out there.
It's amazing. There are people today who are talking about your next step because you're young. You just won an incredibly diverse county. You won going away, and people are connecting the dots. And it's amazing. You went from barely winning a primary in one of the most incredible primary races we'll ever see to now people are thinking about Johnny O's next move already. Is that a weird thing to think about?
Well, my only next move, as far as I'm concerned, is building the best administration I can and governing in a responsible, open, transparent way, and hopefully making some of the improvements in Baltimore County. And that was the reason I ran for this office, and that's what I'm focused on. That's our next move.
Is there a vacation for the Olszewskis in the next week or two?
We're going to take an extended Thanksgiving holiday and get some time away. But otherwise, we're full steam ahead. We did a sine wave first thing this morning in Towson. We'll be in Dundalk tonight. And I'm sure if not today, probably sometime this week, we'll be somewhere over on the west side of the county thanking voters there as well.
Well, a lot to do. Next time you're in, we'll talk about the details of governing because that's next. But congratulations. Really an amazing victory looking at the numbers. And to take it from what I called, and maybe it was unfair, an under-the-radar primary victory, given that it seemed the money and the attention was on Amon and Brochin, and for you to come away with a victory there and to now be the new Baltimore County executive coming up here is pretty amazing, Johnny. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Johnny Olszewski, he has a lot to do today. We appreciate him stopping by our studios. A big win yesterday over Al Redmer Jr. More on that victory and looking at some of these other county races when we come back here on WBAL.